Ready to up your design game? Check out these awesome Canva tips and tricks that will make designing super efficient and smooth. I've got some pretty fresh ones this time too, so even if you're a seasoned Canva user, they may be completely new to you. Ready? Let's do this. Hi, my lovely people, it's Natalia and welcome back to my channel where I help you create better content and grow on social media. Do you know how to resize designs without Canva Pro? How about instantly finding the perfect elements for your graphic? Even if you already know Canva, I'm sharing some nifty tricks to eliminate some pesky little issues and make designing a joy. In this video, I'm showing you 10 new Canva tips and tricks that you probably didn't know about. If I helped you find a tip that you liked, hit that like button and let me know in the comments what it is. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to get even better at Canva and create more engaging content. Let's start off with tip number one, move freely with control. Do you know how sometimes when you have plenty of different elements on a design, Canva tries to help you position your element correctly and it kind of keeps snapping to the boundary lines to align with them? You often end up frustrated because you can't really get it into place just the way you like. Well, here comes this tip. Select your element and instead of just dragging it like this, hold control and you're going to be able to move freely around the canvas with no interruptions. Problem solved. Tip number two, find the perfect elements. It's not always easy to find the right graphics, photos, or other elements to fit your design well. Now, the good news is that we have a personal assistant to help us massively. Click on the new Magic Design Assistant here in the bottom right corner, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and discover all the different suggestions for graphics or photos to match your designs perfectly. You can also tap to see all, and this will expand the selection and give this view in the left panel, where you can also use Magic recommendations even further. Tip number three, resize without Canva Pro. Now, the resize button in Canva Pro is definitely a godsend and it speeds up the content creation workflow a lot. But what to do if you are a free user and still want to resize your designs quickly and efficiently? Well, I got you. The first method is to create a new design with the dimensions that you want to end up with. I'm going to choose the Instagram post in a square format. And then you can go to projects in the left tab in here. And from here, you need to find your design that you want to resize. Let me just go to designs in here. I'm going to go here and that's the one that I want to resize. And if you tap on it, that's going to transpose it into the new canvas, at which point you'd need to slightly adjust the elements to fit the new dimensions. And voila, once you adjust everything, you have a new resized design. Another option is to select and copy everything from the first design. So I'm going to do that in here and just paste it onto the new one and then again adjust, which should be slightly easier because everything is still selected. So like this, I can just put it in here. Now for this method, you'll also have to change the background yourself because it doesn't usually copy unless it's a photo or a graphic that's been previously detached from the background. So I can just click on it in here, click detach image from background. I'm going to copy it, pop it back in here like this. Let me just make it bigger. I just wanted that nice gradient and position it to back. And again, that's your finished design. Both are really effective depending on the difference in dimensions that you're working with. Now let's move on to tip number four, import Instagram post. Have you ever wanted to just grab a post you've already published on Instagram and then use it within your new Canva design? Well, in the second installment of my Canva tips and tricks video, I've shared a hack where you can embed your social media posts in your designs, but how about just grabbing that image or right into the editor? Well, that is possible too. Let's go to apps here in the left panel and scroll down for Instagram. Just in here, it can ask you to actually connect your account and you'll see your entire feed right here. The cool part is that you can also import your own videos with sound, which not only land in the editor, but are also automatically uploaded to your files, meaning that you can reuse them in the future. Of course, that goes for the graphics or the photos from IG as well. This is such a neat trick if you want to reference an old post, reuse a photo or a graphic, traffic in other ways, or if you're planning out your feed visually in Canva. The only downside to that is that it only recognizes the cover image for carousels, and you won't be able to access all the other slides from there. That being said, it's still a pretty cool feature, and reusing parts of old content like clips from my published reels is definitely a time saver. Tip number 5, generate backgrounds. AI has quickly become ubiquitous and is no different here in Canva. I've recently shared 2 videos about the new Canva features, which are full of incredible possibilities for us created by AI, and text to image has just gotten so much better. I want to share a little tip on how you can use it to generate fun backgrounds for your graphics. Let's go to apps here in the left panel, and text to image should be the first thing you see here. Then start describing what you're after. I like to use certain keywords to get these kind of backdrop worthy images, and these include words like pattern, like collage, like texture, and of course like background. Now let's try something like abstract light blue background, and then you can start choosing a specific style. I've gotten great results with both 3D and with watercolor of all things, so definitely experiment here. I'm just going to choose watercolor at this occasion and choose the portrait ratio. Let's generate. Okay, these are quite fun, but definitely not what I was looking for. So we can always kind of change the transparency, but I'm going to go back and change the style to 3D. Let's hope that this is going to give me something a little bit different. Ooh, fun. Yes, definitely. I can see working with this one, for example. So that's quite a cool one. I'm going to grab this one as well, because every single time I tap on it, it gets uploaded to my own uploads in here. So that's quite a fun way to kind of keep gathering them in your uploads. As you can see, I've got plenty in here that I've used previously. I'm just going to show you this design, for example. That little background from here is actually used underneath this one. This is another one that I've used with a generated image from text to image. So that's quite a fun, neat feature to try out for generating your backgrounds. Okay, we're halfway through the video. I hope you're enjoying yourself. If so, leave me a thumbs up. It really makes me smile and helps me out a ton. But if you want to become super confident in Canva and use it to accelerate your business and your social media, make sure you sign up on the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course. The link is in the description box. And let's move on to tip number 6, blur photo background. We all love a bit of an artistic bouquet in our photos, but it's not always possible to get it, especially when you're using existing photos from the library. Well, you can blur your background ever so slightly to get this kind of effect in Canva. First, select an image with a clear subject like a person or an animal or just something that stands out distinctly in the foreground and is at some distance from the background. Then go to edit photo at the very top, switch to the new editor if you haven't already, and then select the second tab, adjust. From the drop-down menu, choose background, wait a second for it to process, and then scroll all the way down to the texture section and reduce the sharpness on the slider. Make sure to work gently for a more natural effect, but there are photos where you'll be able to go all the way down. Now, if it's not enough of a blur for you, you can duplicate the photo. I'm just going to pop it on top and then go to transparency and drop it just to be able to align it perfectly with your canvas, just like this. Let's go back to transparency and pop it to 100%, and then go to edit photo at the top and go to background remover to remove the background. Now you should have something that's removed at the very top. I'm just going to make it smaller, and then I'll select the one in the background. So the background is selected now. Let's go to edit photo at the top again and go to blur, and then move the slider ever so slightly. Now I wouldn't go above 10 just because the subject then blurs too much outside of the boundaries that are covered by our cutout. So for a more natural effect, just stick to the lower end, but this should still give you a nice enough blur in the background. Let's compare it to this one, and you can definitely see that this one has a lot more sharpness and this one is nicely blurred. Tip 7, bulk edit photos. Displaying your products online just got so much easier. Now you can bulk upload your product photos and Canva will automatically prepare them for you so you can use them on your website or anywhere else. Now to do this, go to the Canva homepage, click apps in the left panel in here, then select product photos, and then click choose photos here in the middle. Upload up to 10 images of your products. I'm just going to select these five and then hit next. And from here, you can select a style. I'm going to go for this pewter blue in here and hit apply. Let Canva do its thing. And in a moment, you'll have a pack ready to use on your website and your designs. Now let's click on it in here. And you can see that you can download my prepared photos. Of course, not all of them will work just because it's just an example, but I want to show you another thing that's quite a random side note, I think. Once you upload your images, I'm going to upload the bunch of cars that I've got in here, and you can actually select automotive. And then from here, I'm just going to, let's say, select showroom, maybe this one, let's apply. And you've got your cars sorted as well. So I suppose if you're a used car salesman, Canva got you covered apparently. All right, let's move on to tip number 8, change colors with duotone. Now, duotone is such a slept on feature in Canva as it really allows you to get some interesting effects with it. I want to show you how you can change the color of your backgrounds or textures to match the style of your design or simply go with your branding. Now, I've got this background here and it's definitely kind of clashing with the rest of the elements. I can just select it in here, go to edit photo at the top again, and then select duotone. From here, we've got plenty of different presets already. I'm going to scroll down and maybe just go for the classic, but that's not the end. I can change the color of the highlight and the shadow so that my brand colors are kept consistent. So I'm just going to do this now. Just like this, maybe add a bit of a blue on top, ever so slightly. And here we go. It's a great tip for those moments when the image is kind of perfect, but the colors are just not giving. So let's go to tip number 9, fix your frames. Frames are so helpful when you design, especially when you're trying to add some visual interest to your graphics. However, when they're rotated like this tablet frame right here or this abstract frame there, the images are facing the wrong direction and this is how you fix it. So now instead of dragging your image like this into the frame that gets rotated, you want to just add it to your canvas or just simply click on it and then rotate it in the opposite direction. Let's go for a 90 in here, then drag it into the frame and voila, it's sitting there correctly. You may need to rotate your image in different directions depending on how the frame was rotated, but it's definitely a very, very simple fix. Tip number 10, replace text. If you ever had to change something on multiple pages of your design, you know it can be a real pain, especially with those bigger designs. It can be things like your name, your website, a date of an event, or an Instagram handle like this one right here. I have my 30 designs I generated with Canva Bulk Create. Now, by the way, check out this video next to learn how to automatically generate multiple designs in just a few clicks. But for now, I'm going to show you this simple trick that will help you change text super fast. Let's go to File here at the top and go to Find and Replace Text. You can just click on it, but I'm going to use Control F, and that's going to pull up this little pop-out box. Type what you want to swap in Find. That's going to be really great sight for me in here. And type what you want to replace it with in the second box. I'm going to paste my own Instagram handle at Natalia Kalinska. And now let's go to Replace All. Now, all of my IG handles are sorted and I don't have to do it manually for each and every one of these. Super fast, super quick. Have you been aware of these tips already? Drop me a comment down below, and if you've discovered something new today, I'd love to hear which one of these tricks you'll be trying out first. Now, that's just 10 Canva tips I've shared with you today, but I have many, many more in my previous videos, so check them out in the description box or just watch this playlist right here to learn a ton of useful skills in Canva. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe because there's so much I have in store for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.